When you start graduate school, you think I'm going to have to do a bunch of experiments, but you don't think I need to learn how to think.
What makes Rockefeller such a special place to be a graduate student is that we have the resources to be able to focus on really the questions at the leading edge of different fields.
Rockefeller's graduate program was really built on the idea of being a scientific apprentice with another scientist.
You were going to have a hands-on education in doing biology research on important biomedical problems.
Your major interaction is with the person that you see every day in the lab. And so developing a relationship with that person is incredibly important. When I came to Rockefeller, I knew that I wanted to do something within the greater field of immunology. I decided to rotate with Michelle Nussenzweig. A couple years before I joined the lab transitioned into studying HIV, and I wanted to tackle that problem. It ended up being a really good fit, and so I joined right after that rotation.
The graduate students are absolutely the key to this whole thing. And one of the great privileges of being at Rockefeller is working with these amazing students who come here. I myself was a student here. It was a wonderful experience for me, and I really cherish working with the students.
We have about 25 students join each year. We have 70 truly outstanding faculty with whom graduate students can work. Now, that experience of being at a small, focused institution is one that has real benefits. But there are also benefits associated with the bigger community that we have here as part of Rockefeller. So in our immediate vicinity, we have the Weill Cornell Medical School, which has graduate programs and an MD-PhD program that we share with them. And we also have the Sloan Kettering Institute.
One of the myths that I would love to dispel about Rockefeller is that everyone here comes in perfect and that there's no room for error. And I think it's the exact opposite. This place really expects you to take those risks when it comes to your work and to think of the craziest idea and go for it.
You walk in the front gates and you are in a beautiful garden with trees and grass and the peaceful quiet of a real oasis. But when you walk out the gates, you're on York Avenue, you're a minute away from a subway, and you can go hear music, you can go to a play, you can go to a sports game.
We provide safe, affordable housing close to campus that makes your living situation very easy. For students, I think you'll never be lost in a crowd here.
One of the roles that I play is really to think about all the options that a student will have with a PhD from Rockefeller. From the beginning, I'm able to talk about the resources that we provide that will prepare students for either the academic path or any other career path.
We have students representing the population of the United States, but also the population of the world.
What we know from the research is that diversity leads to innovation. We know that by surrounding ourselves with people who have different lived experiences, who have different points of view, causes us to think a little bit differently about problems that we are seeking to solve and the challenges that we face. At Rockefeller, we believe that collaboration is key to doing great innovative science. And you can see that from the way that we design our buildings, that focus on having open spaces for people to meet and to talk.
Graduate students are really the laboratory. I am their leader and their cheerleader. Graduate students have their own ideas, their own interests, and they are given as much autonomy as they want to. I always meet with students every week, and we just discuss experiments as they come, and by the time they're done, graduate students are extremely autonomous. And some of them do run their own laboratories at the end of their graduate school here.
Being able to be on the edge of known and unknown for your whole career is sort of a gift and a joy.
When I think about a student entering graduate school now, I find it so exciting because it's really just the most exciting time to be a scientist.
We learned from the very beginning that having original thought, having new ideas and tackling new ideas is the bread and butter of our future as scientists.